Whiskey Jason here, whiskey from the viewpoint of an American in Germany tasting rare and exotic whiskeys. What do I have? Look at these two little sweet, tiny little Jack Daniel bottles. Jack Daniel's Tennessee Travelers, sweet and oaky, straight Tennessee whiskey, limited edition. This is the number one. And over here we have the Jack Daniel's Tennessee Travelers, bold and spicy, straight Tennessee rye whiskey, limited edition number two. So both of these cost me 30 euros. Why did they do 0.5 liters when it's illegal in America, I think? Well, at travel retail, you can actually buy 1 liter of alcohol per person. Ta-da! 1 liter, two together. All right, so they did have some good thoughts there. What am I going to compare it to? I'm going to compare it to Jack Daniel's 100 Travel Retail Bottled and Bond. 50%, as we know, bottle and bond has to be. This is a 1 liter bottle. I paid 45 euros for this 2 years ago. So forgive me, I have something left in my glass from my video before. So I'm going to compare it to this. Standard Jack Daniel mash bill, 80% corn, 12% barley, and 8% rye. No problem there. 10 feet of sugar maple charcoal. I guess that's normal. I'm not the biggest Jack Daniel fan of the world. Toasted in charred barrels and filled at 107 proof for us Europeans, 53.5%. Many master distillers actually say that 107 is the best proof for a bourbon. Oh, by the way, master distiller, look at the signature on this. Chris, yeah, I think it's Fletcher if I remember correctly. He actually has his name on here. I looked everywhere on this old bottle. On this old bottle and this old box, I cannot find the name of the old distillery anywhere. Is that something new now? I don't know. So, is that really important in today's bourbon whiskey drinking, Tennessee whiskey drinking community? I don't know. But he did get his name on here. All right, so we have a screw cap on both of these that should not deter from the pleasure that we get from these tiny little bottles here, but hey, why not? First of all, the color. I think you can see this. The four-year-old bottled and bond is... I'm sorry, that's not correct. Let's start. I'm just going to leave this in here and start all again. The bottled and bond 100 proof is darker than the... This is a straight Tennessee whiskey, so it is 4 years old. And with 53.5% is not as dark. Did they use older bottles here? I don't know. You never know anything about Jack Daniel's, about how old it is. They got a nice little video here about the whole thing, and they said maturation year for year. Yeah, well, you could have said day for day, month for month, week for week, year for year. All right, so we do have a 10-year-old Jack Daniel's out there for the first time in, I don't know, 40-some, four decades or whatever. Yay, there's a finally age statement on Jack Daniel's. Thank you very much. Yay. But, hey, why not? Okay, on the nose. Would I recognize it as Jack Daniel's? I'm going to say yes. Oh, by the way, I'm going to bash on Jack Daniel's a tiny little bit, but I love the single barrel proof here with 64.5%. This is one of the best bottles you can buy for money out there, right? 75 euros, 45 euros. This is 0.7, this is one liter, 29 euros, which means 60 euros compared to 45 euros. Ouch. All right, price increase. This is much complex. There's a density of flavor here. Now, that just might be due to the fact that this has been open the bottle now for almost 2 years. I am not a big drinker of the Jack Daniel's. I do have a sample list, and it's on the sample list, and people every once in a while order it, and I fill it up, and one day this bottle is going to be gone, and I'm not going to buy a new one. All right, so not my preferred cup of tea. If I'm going to drink anything from Jack Daniel's, it's going to be this. All right, that's what I like, that's what I love, that's what I go for. And or, I must admit, there's a second bottle I will also buy again and go for, and that is the Jack Daniel's single barrel rye. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay, I'm sorry. I only have 45%. I think there was some single barrel proof rye out there in the States, but none of that made it over here to Europe. At least I did not see any of it, but I did see some Instagram pictures, and I was very, very sad that I didn't get to try it. I was happy for those that did because everyone was fantastically raving about it. All right. Cheers. There is that little bit of an acetone moment. There is a certain burn here. There is an astringency. There's a light honey moment. There is a nice, almost a tiny little bit of molasses thrown in there for good measure. Is it good? Is it okay? Yeah. Is it bad? No. This is a C whiskey. There is a tiny little bit of an oaky spice here, which almost surprises me. Let's take a look at the official tasting notes. Caramel, yes. Vanilla, yes. Toasted oak, yes. Concentrates at mid palate, balance of sweet and oak. Great mixer. I don't know if I'm gonna buy a 60 € bottle, 1.1 liter, and mix it. All right, that's a little bit expensive for me. On the aroma, it's a balanced character, sweet, oaky, medium body, and the finish is creamy and clean. I'm not sure about the creamy, and I'm not sure about the clean part. There is a little bit more of an oak spice that goes on there. Good. Going over to the bottle and bond, 50% here from Tennessee. Let's see here. Anywhere. I'm looking here. Yep, here at the bottom. So we have the DSP number 101, and over here it's actually where was it? Was it more prominent here? I thought I saw it here as well, didn't I? Wow, I can't find it. I guess it isn't here, or is it? Nope. It was only there. Okay, wow. So I guess it was on the bottle that caught my attention there. Sorry. They did not put it on. They put the signature of the distiller, though. Yay. Yay. So try the bottle bond, 100 proof. Much rounder, silkier, coherent, compact. There's a nice honey, forest honey note coming off of this. Much more of a silky moment. That's rough around the edges. And there is only 3.5% differentiating the two of them. I would go for this any day of the year. It's cheaper, 45 € versus over here, 60 €. Now, I've actually seen some people selling this in Germany for 45 € as a 0.5 liter, and this was 45 € for the 1 liter bottle. All right. Now, it is a little difficult to get. You have to be travel retail, which means officially it's over here in Europe through Heinemann. Heinemann is the shore, the stop, the travel retail. Tail shops at the airports and maybe even wherever else you travel, and it's travel retail. And there is one place in Germany, it's called the Frankfurt Airport Shop. If you go there, you don't need to show a ticket and you can still buy it. And the interesting thing is, if you buy two bottles, number one and number two, you actually get it sent to your home free of charge, free shipping, because you go over the 50 € limit. Yay. And everyone's happy. Cheapest place to buy it, and so on. I have no idea if Frankfurt Airport Shop will send outside of Germany. Don't know. Don't live outside of Germany, but it might be actually a good try to do that. All right. So this is definitely more of a C plus, and this is definitely a C. Value for money also a C plus. This is more of a C minus, to be very honest. There are so many other things I would pay. It's basically like a 45 € bottle at 0.7. This is 45 at 1 liter. I can buy a lot of good stuff over here for that price instead. I'm going to say Evan Williams single barrel. I'm going to say Johnny Drum. I'm going to say Knob Creek. I'm going to say Maker's 46. And many, many, many other things I could buy instead of this. And they've all those things I've just listed taste better. So sorry. So, question of the day. What is your favorite Jack Daniel's product? I know my favorite. Single barrel, barrel proof. Yay. I do like the rye, and I did like the 27. Beautiful bottle. Little too expensive for what you get. Sinatra was way too expensive for what you get, and many other things are okay. But I am definitely not a big Jack Daniel's fan yet. Let's see what happens in the future. All the best. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for liking, sharing, subscribing, and telling others. See you soon. Whiskey Jason. Bye-bye.